for a second round showdown as the sixth seed Florida Gators host the Notre Dame Fighting Irish in the first ever meeting between these two schools. Sean Salisbury with you this afternoon as this matchup set to feature two of the top attacking units in the country. They put up big numbers on Friday and wins over Jacksonville for Florida, Mercer for Notre Dame, and the winner will play the victor at Boston College and Penn, set to get underway in Chestnut Hill in an hour. Well, for the Florida Gators, it has not exactly been smooth sailing throughout this 12-game win streak, but Sarah Resnick and Mandy O'Leary, after Friday's 13-7 win over Jacksonville, saying sometimes it's this team's heart over their talent, and the way this team continues to shine late in games and fourth quarters have been the separation in being 17-3 this year and maybe having a couple more losses and maybe being on the road in this second round matchup. Meanwhile, for Notre Dame, you wonder how a team would look after 2 weeks following an ACC semifinal loss to Boston College. Well, they shattered each and every expectation you might have had. Put up a program record 21 goals in the win over Mercer, 8 of them in the first quarter. Casey Choma had a career-high 10 points on 6 goals. And after that early lead, even after a lightning delay, even as the rain was coming down late in that one, the Fighting Irish built that big lead and never looked back. Thankfully, no rain in the forecast today. It's an 83-degree day in Gainesville. UV index a little high, but not too humid. Just perfect for this time of year in mid-May. Liz Harrison steps into the circle for the Gators wearing white. All ACC junior Kelly Dennis in the navy blue for the Fighting Irish. Winner to the quarterfinals of the NCAA tournament. And we're underway. Mary Kelly Doherty misplayed it for a moment. And after a foul on Florida, they'll award possession to Dennis. Notre Dame coming into this game 14-5. Mentioned the big win they had, 21-6 over Mercer. Scored 8 goals on 14 shots in the first frame. Led 11-2 at the half, did not slow down one bit. Trying to break through Florida's ride here. Nice little juke from Keelan Schlageter. And the Notre Dame attack, which averages 15.5 goals per game this year, the 8th highest scoring offense in the country. They'll look to get to work right away. Jane McAvoy sets it up top. This is Dennis, now over to Doherty. And now Jackie Wolak. 6 goals on Friday, looks inside, quick shot and score. On the doorstep for Madison Ahern. And off the draw, Notre Dame strikes first. You see it on display in the opening possession. Sarah Resnick, who had a program record 17 saves against the Jacksonville Dolphins Friday, we'll need a similar superhuman performance if the Gators are to advance to the quarterfinals. Wolak with her 46th assist of the season. Ahern with her 60th goal. And Liz Harrison has the draw for UF. No, they'll call a hold. So Notre Dame with possession once again. Ahern with the opening score. Here's Casey Choma, the captain from New York. Choma and Ahern last summer playing for Florida head coach Mandy O'Leary for Team USA in the World Championship Sixes. This is Doherty down the lane. Choma picked up by Sars on the doorstep, denied. The rebound goes to the Fighting Irish. Shot clock back to 60 after Resnick's first save. Florida's all-time leader in saves set that last Saturday in a win over James Madison. Big reason why Florida jumped up as the number six seed. There's Choma, couldn't get it there. Rolling around the crease, and Resnick finally secures it. Florida looking to clear. Nice pass from Browndorf to Paisley Egan. And the senior will clear it for Florida. That'll set the stage for this offense. Didn't get off to their fastest start on Friday as Paisley Egan quickly draws the shooting space call. Even though Florida this season holding a plus 50 margin in the first quarter, down the back half of the regular season as the horn stops play at the scorer's table, it's really been Florida's second quarters and even fourth quarters in the last three games where they have broken through and just flat out dominated. Paisley Egan, 14 goals on the year. Looks to pass it out. Couldn't get it cleanly to Hall, who has been on a scoring tear as of late. This is Emily Heller. Puts it in! An absolute laser beam out of the stick of Emily Heller. And the AAC Midfielder of the Year ties us up at one. Dubbed as the most athletic player on her team by head coach Mandy O'Leary. The do-it-all midfielder who's starting to earn that All-American recognition was named to the Towarton watch list for the first time in her career earlier this season. Can't say enough about what she does between the 30s on defense and offense. As she nets her 38th goal of the year. See those kinds of plays where even just inside the eight, she'll let it rip. Beats Callahan there. Mandy says the joke on the team is we just shrug our shoulders and say, that's Emily. No other way to put it. Florida scores on its opening possession. Egan had a chance, couldn't reel it in. Nice job by Allie McHugh, but she throws it away. Loose to the midfield, and Madison Waters has it. The USC transfer looks back for Shelton Sars. First-year starter moving back from midfield to defense. That Florida backline only returning one starter, and it's the captain right here, Kat Flaherty. It's been the defense that's carried Florida in the last few games. Holding their last three opponents under 10 goals. Hall looks to set it up. Right on the money. To Ashley Gonzalez. And the Gators grab the lead. So off the turnover, Florida takes advantage. They will have to have another gritty effort against one of the best draw units in the country. That's what's incredible about this attacking unit for Florida, as this one goes all the way to the restraining line and picked out of the air by Ahern. Great job by the 5'8 senior to reach out and pull it out of the pack. So Hall, who moved to number 5 in the record books for most assists in a Florida career on Friday, had 3 of them against Jacksonville. Her first today gives Florida the lead, but for how long? Kristen Shanahan works it back to X. This is McAvoy. Nowhere near her intended target. And the freshman Teresa Bragg is off and running. Her pass is knocked down, and Florida will keep it. Bragg, the freshman who has started every single game this year on defense. The daughter of 2 former Terrapin athletes. Her mom, Helena, a 2-time national champion for the women of the Maryland lacrosse program. Dad, Jamie, on the football team. Taylor Wareheim, national champion with North Carolina last season out there. Hall with a run, goes to LaPinto. Florida's number 1 scorer this year, swings it back up. LaPinto curls around the crease and finds the back of the net. You give her that much space, she will make you pay. LaPinto's 59th goal of the year, a cerebral one. Anya Massacre just a step late, and that's all the difference. Timeout Notre Dame with 9:23 to play in the first quarter. 3 straight goals by the Gators sends us to a timeout on the field. 3-1 early in this second round matchup between Florida and Notre Dame. Three-one Florida after Emma LaPinto's goal moments ago. The star sophomore who has shattered the glass ceiling after scoring nearly 100 points last year, LaPinto earning the honor as a top 25 Towariton nominee in her second season. Has been the player to really carry Florida's offense throughout this 17-3 season. Dennison Harrison to duel on top of the NCAA logo again. And a false start called on Florida. For Notre Dame, bit of a rocky start here, almost 6 minutes in. Nice job by Brandorf. They'll call her for a foul, though. And they will bring her back to the 12 instead of the 8. But after outscoring the Bears 8-0 in the first quarter on Friday, Notre Dame's first quarter margin going into today, 105-35 this season. And now the flag will come up behind the play. Florida might have been caught not marking somebody. And that awards Notre Dame with a free position shot. This will be for Jane McAvoy, the senior from Potomac, Maryland. Let's it fly, and it's saved by Sarah Resnick. The heartbeat of this program. That pass sails over the head of Sars. Flaherty collects, back to Bragg. Now to Egan. After a couple of whistles, official will stop play. And just make her reset there. Flaherty looking for help, finds an outlet in Heller. Massacre, tight on LaPinto, but too much contact there. Gonzalez, a great feeder herself, will try to set it up to Hall, though she was right in front. Notre Dame gets its first defensive stop. Julia Carr, the sophomore, looks to clear. Notre Dame making its 16th NCAA appearance this year, trying to get back to the quarterfinals for a sixth time in program history. Did it in 2021 when they were the number 5 seed. But now they have to do something today that they've never done. And that's win a true road game in the NCAA tournament. They're 0-10 all time. Free lane, and they take advantage. Off the miscommunication, Jackie Wolak takes advantage. Flaherty and Browndorf got tied up. Something that cannot happen against the three-headed monster of Choma, Ahern, and Wolak. Even for a player that's top 10 in the NCAA in assists this year, it's been her goal-scoring ability. Had 6 on Friday, her first today. Cuts the Florida lead to 3-2. Draw goes right to Sars. Emerson Cabrera forced to retreat. Florida, 3 goals on 3 shots early. Part of the message Mandy O'Leary has really put into her team's head of valuing possession. Hall gives it back to Caitlin Davies. Down the lane, couldn't bounce it in. Callahan extended her leg, and the 6-foot junior gets her first stop. Just inside of 5.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Winner of this game will meet the victor of Boston College and Penn. That game getting underway at 1 o'clock in Chestnut Hill. 8 great games today in this second round. All quarterfinal games will be played on Thursday. Brandorf keeping an eye on Ahern, and another hold away from the ball will give Notre Dame a free position shot. Allie McHugh, only 4 goals this year. But we'll have a great angle to try and tie this game up. Can't do it there. Ahern backs it up. Shot clock reset to 60. As this shot misfires, Choma curls right back around, trying to go middle, comes outside the arc. So they will credit Sarah Resnick with a save there. Ahern, first team all ACC member, one of 7 conference honorees. It's a program record for Notre Dame to have that many players listed in the postseason awards, and we'll have another whistle against the Gators. It has to be the 4th whistle this first quarter away from the ball. And now Wolak, the 49% shooter. She can't put it on target. Emerson Cabrera begging for the call. Choma quickly in on the restart. 12 on the timer. And a charge is called. Extended that arm out, and it was enough to draw the whistle. Off the catch, this is Josie Hahn. Sophomore out there with Wareheim, Cabrera, Pavanelli, Hall, and Lapinto. Gonzalez there too. That's who catches this pass. Hall on an island. Has it knocked loose. And it's flicked away. A brilliant move by Grace Wigan. Florida gives it away again. Working in transition on the doorstep. Just put wide. Hannah Dorney had a great chance to tie it up. Offense catches their breath. Florida scored 3 straight goals in a hurry. since that timeout by Christine Halfpenny 7 minutes ago. Notre Dame has seemed to calm down. Wolak gets by, but couldn't beat Resnick. Already her fifth save of the quarter. And the All-American bringing her game to another level in this NCAA tournament. Hard to believe Sarah Resnick became a goalie at a young age by accident when her dad thought she was going to a soccer tryout. Told her to be brave and try to be a goalie. Florida can't connect on the pass inside the eight. That's just another giveaway. Third of the quarter, but now back-to-back possessions. Especially as Florida has struggled a bit in the draw unit against the elite teams this year. Goes back to that conversation of valuing possession. Notre Dame holds the shot advantage 10-4. Mary Kelly Doherty. Dennis. Fouled by Waters. But not a free position shot. Ahern has to move quickly. Wolak probing with 10. Schlageter got free, rings it off the pipe, and time expires. But there will be a yellow card on a hit to the head. Well, it was that bang-bang play at the end of the quarter. They'll charge Waters with the yellow. Florida fans below were asking for a dangerous act on the follow-through. A chaotic sequence to end a good first 15 minutes in this one. Florida with a 3-goal run early. Holds the advantage 3-2 after one in Gainesville. Number 6 seed Florida holds the early advantage in the first half over Notre Dame, but it's the Fighting Irish who will have the advantage entering the second period. Christine Halfpenny in her 12th year has started to make the ascent in the ACC even against those yearly powers, as Boston College has found a way to be a perennial contender for Memorial Day weekend, even winning national championships. Also with Syracuse trying to break through into that same realm, with North Carolina, the defending champs, Notre Dame, looking like they're sticking around and can be that fourth team that can always compete in the ACC. For Florida, especially for this group, tournament play, nothing new, even on this field. Won six straight tournament games at home, 11-4 all-time at the Diz. And since the program began back in 2010, Florida's home record, 126-22. After the yellow card on Madison Waters at the end of the first quarter, Kelly Dennis will have possession as Notre Dame looks to tie. Dorney, one of the captains for Notre Dame. Their 79th career game, and as soon as the super senior lets it go, there's a whistle to stop play. Had to change the shot clock there, bring it down a few seconds. Molak already with a couple of points. Choma sets it up. And there's the score. Jackie Wolak's second score ties us up at three, and Notre Dame takes advantage of the first woman up opportunity today. That's what will be the key for Notre Dame. How can its top three score will them to a win to the quarterfinal round? That's where the struggles have been in a 14-5 season, but those five losses, nothing to be upset with. Four of those defeats are to the top three seeds. They lost at Northwestern, at Syracuse, twice to Boston College, and the only other one in Charlottesville to Virginia. The draw plucked out of the air by Doherty. Notre Dame can try to retake the lead for the first time since it was 1-0 in the opening minutes. Even with some of those blemishes on the schedule, Notre Dame still has that win over North Carolina, where everything came together that day in South Bend. But that was April 1st. Now 6 weeks later, and they find a way to get another top 10 win. Wolak starting to feel it. Already with a hat trick. And this one, the go-ahead goal. Got by Flaherty one-on-one, and Resnick guessed far post. She went upstairs instead. Notre Dame scored the last three goals. That's where the problem starts to come for Florida. Notre Dame has won six of the first seven draws and outshot Florida 13-4. Emily Diaz in the circle, fighting for that ball. It's Paisley Egan who will claim it. Florida finally back in its attacking zone after a couple of turnovers late in the first period. Not usually a mistake-prone team. They had the seventh fewest turnovers in the country this season. Hall got by the defense and puts it in. Masterful move by Maggie Hall. Her first goal today knots us up at four. Great footwork from Hall. Former top recruit out of Maryland a couple seasons ago. And she has turned into a full-time star for the Gators. Even when the other two starters on the attacking line are Tawarton nominees, Pavanelli top 25 last year, Lapinto top 25 this year. It's Hall who entering this second round game. In her last seven times she's taken the field, she's had 28 points and at least four in every game. Hall already up to 3 points in the first half. And after her first goal, Notre Dame will take the draw. We'll look to retake the lead again. Talk about Florida's talent. Notre Dame with six All-Americans named by U.S. Lacrosse Magazine as some of those accolades start to trickle in this time of the year after the regular season and conference tournaments. Ahern was one of them. Can't connect on the pass, and Resnick pulls it out of the crease. Now one of the best clearing teams in the country. Looks to get out in space. Nice lob from Flaherty to Waters. Lapinto finds some breathing room. Falls to her knees with Massacre right there, and they pick off the pass. Nice swarm coming in late by Grace Wigan. She's been active early on the defensive side. Wigan, a former top 10 recruit herself, bringing her A game today. Florida, five shots, four turnovers. Jomo one-on-one, tried to flip it back to a teammate. It was knocked down. And a foul called on Sars. And Notre Dame trying to work too quick on the restart. Will be forced to give back possession. Well, an awkward sequence. And Notre Dame, too quick and in a hurry, winds up handing it back to Florida. Heller feeds LaPinto. Waters out to Egan. All the starters out there for Mandy O'Leary's offense. Nice move by Heller to the middle. Denied. Ball loose in front. And Notre Dame's defense gives it back to their keeper. And a strong outlet to Doherty. Nice whack from behind. That ball's loose. Choma and Sars had no idea it was going to them. And the Notre Dame captain throwing her left hand out, tells everybody to settle. Shanahan tries her luck, got free, and goes low for the goal. Didn't have a goal for just the fifth time all season on Friday. Breaks down Bragg, and that spot has been one that's worked a couple of times against Resnick today. After two first quarter goals for one of the top scoring offenses in the country, they have come alive in the first few minutes of the second. Florida ball. Off the foul, Davies gives it to Hall. Some of the second line coming out there with Hahn, Wareheim. Gonzalez trots on too. She'll be at X. LaPinto taking on a different role. Pavanelli, five goals Friday, all in the second half. I believe away from the ball, it was Hall who might have gotten hit. It'll be Gonzalez to go to the eight. She's 2 of 7 on free position shots this year. See if she calls her own number here on one of the best feeders in Florida's program history. Seventh all-time in assists. Does have 11 goals this year, but she'll pass it out. Pavanelli blows by and finishes in front. Both offenses starting to find their grooves. Wolak taking charge for Notre Dame now. Danielle Pavanelli became the 11th player in program history with 200 plus points on Friday. Her first goal today ties us up at 5. We step aside at the Diz. We got a great one in this second round matchup midway through the second quarter. Back and forth we go in this matchup between Florida and Notre Dame. The first time these two schools have ever met. Florida began its program in 2010, Notre Dame in 1997. And as they continue each to try and go up and up the ladder to be with the Carolinas, the Marylands, the Syracuses, Northwesterns, Boston Colleges, such little separation. But there's a big reason why you always see those same five schools play Memorial Day weekend for a national championship. Winner here will have a chance to get to Cary, North Carolina on Thursday. And after Caitlin Davies was taken down off of Florida's draw control. Midway through the second quarter, if they clear, chance to retake the lead as Bragg got it across, then lost it, and a push from behind will give it to Notre Dame. Doherty fires to Choma. Thought about attacking, puts the brakes on. We'll trot over. Doherty with a great spin, but denied. Resnick rises up. That's her sixth save. Wolak defended by Flaherty. Already with three goals, looking to feed here. Dennis thought about it, didn't get the whistle. And Choma has her shot deflected into the air. And another whistle stops play. Hold on, Florida. Gators racking up the fouls in this first half. Now Dennis will take it from the arc. And Dennis buries it. Third goal of the tournament for Kelly Dennis. One too many miscues from Florida in this first half has given Notre Dame ample opportunities to stay in front. Think of the turnover after you won the draw. And even there, Resnick with a couple of nice saves. Well, when you give a team like Notre Dame three, four chances on one possession, you're really testing your luck. Dennis, the one who dominates the draw. Second most in a single season in Notre Dame history with 111 entering the tournament. And Dennis continue to put in work on offense and between the 30s. Doherty with the goal. Florida out of position. And Notre Dame starting to surge in the second quarter. Florida not ready for Notre Dame to take advantage. The second lapse we've seen from that defense this half. And Notre Dame really starting to step up too. Florida led 3-1 about 6 minutes into the first quarter. Scored three goals on the first three shots. But after a Christine Halfpenny timeout, it has pretty much been all Notre Dame despite the two-goal margin. You can only ask so much from Sarah Resnick if you're Florida. Already with seven saves when shots are 18-7. Got to find a way to make some other plays. Such a disparity because Notre Dame, one of the best draw units in the country, is doing what they do best. Pavanelli will give chase and hit the midsection of Schlageter, and that will be a yellow. Florida not getting away with anything today. Another whistle against them will put them in a world of trouble with 5:07 left in the first half. The head of Pavanelli's stick went right to the ribcage of Schlageter. A little too careless, a little too much contact for the official's liking. Now Notre Dame with a great chance to go up three. One for one on the advantage today. McAvoy. Shanahan, who has a goal. Good ball movement from Notre Dame. Everybody getting a touch. And they'll get the call there. Another free position shot. Off the mark. Wolak misses. McAvoy will have it. Now Wolak picks up the pace. Stop down low. A whole mass of humanity converges for the rebound, and Notre Dame has it. They're starting to dominate in every facet of the game late in this first half. Ahern winds it up, and there's shooting space. And that's what's starting to become the difference. How many times is Notre Dame getting multiple chances to score on one possession? Ahern got it. Notre Dame with the last three goals. On the last, from the first team, all ACC attacker, Madison Ahern. Florida trying to stop the bleeding, calls timeout with 3:57 left in the half. Just two goals in the last 20 minutes for the Gators. Because of some turnovers, but they've been playing a lot of defense in the first half. Reggie Thorpe, the assistant coach in his second season under Mandy O'Leary, tasked with leading this defense that only returned one starter from last year's team that went to the quarterfinals. He's had some brilliant game plans as of late. Florida took down, at the time, number six, James Madison, now the seventh seed in this year's NCAA tournament, a 9-8 victory last Saturday in Philadelphia to win Florida's 10th conference tournament title. But Notre Dame, this is what they've wanted to see. A team that only put up four goals in the ACC semifinals against Boston College. Two of those free position goals. After a heartbreaking one-goal loss at home to the Eagles earlier this year. Will a third time be the charm for the Fighting Irish? If they advance today, along with Boston College, as the number three seed, set for first draw in the next couple of minutes against Penn. Notre Dame really has the hosts on their heels. All the momentum in their favor with 3:57 left in the second quarter. Liz Harrison will go back into the circle as Florida looks for a much-needed draw out of the break. Sars trying to chase it down, couldn't get it. A couple of players down on the field. Notre Dame guilty there. Gonzalez handles. Florida with just two goals so far in the second quarter. Pavanelli right in front. Rings it off the pipe. They will not give it to her. The flag was up, but they let her continue play. Another bad break for Florida. Now with 3 minutes to play and a three-goal lead. Obviously for a draw unit that's this good and an attack that's this good, start going up by four, maybe even five goals. Start to change that strategy just a little bit. Feel good about your chances advancing. Notre Dame already with six goals in the quarter. Trying to take advantage of this monster frame. Wolak, the head of the snake, can't put it in. She's been brilliant, though, with three goals. Rob there. And Florida with a dangerous pass in the midfield. Read well by Keelan Schlageter. Just an unforced error with about 2 minutes left in the half. Florida's mistakes proving costly. Ahern one-on-one with Brandorf. Gets to the middle, and she hits the post. The Iron with a couple of big stops late in the half. Choma picks up the pace. Outlets to Shanahan. Now in the final minute of the half. Notre Dame still with ample time on the shot clock. Choma can't get any separation. Now down to 15. Timer at 10. Ahern pushed back. Now with 5, waves everybody off. Going at the freshman Davies with 2. Hit the side of the net. Final half minute, Florida's got a push. After spending the last 90 seconds on defense, it's a welcome stop as they try to get it across and get a quality look. Egan with 5, flipping it in front to Heller. Notre Dame does a nice job packing it in. And a strong second quarter for the Fighting Irish. The difference, they outscore Florida 6-2. And in this second round battle, it's Notre Dame on top. 30 minutes down, 30 minutes to go. 8-5 our score in Gainesville. The Fighting Irish ahead thanks to 3 goals and an assist from first-team All-ACC member Jackie Wolak. Both teams coming out of the locker room and back onto the field here in Gainesville. Cloudy but still warm in this second round Sunday. Notre Dame with 6 goals in the second quarter have the advantage. And before the start of the third quarter, we'll take a look at some of our first half stats. And winning 10 of the 15 draws, Notre Dame with a clear advantage in the shot department. But it's Sarah Resnick once again. She has made it known this is her final season of college lacrosse. She's done after this year. She has poured her heart and soul into this team. The all-time saves leader with 9 of them, and Florida plus 1 on turnovers, but those 6 so much more costly when you see the number of shots. But Florida has had some comeback victories this year. Nothing new to them, even at this stage in the game. Trailed against James Madison last week in the AAC championship. Trailed against East Carolina in the AAC semifinals. For Notre Dame, this is a comfortable spot for them. Because when they aren't trailing at half, they're 9-0 this year. A lot of work for Maggie Hall and Emma LaPinto to do if and when Florida can get more offensive possessions. Not the same, but we'll say close enough as Notre Dame breaks the huddle. Florida has a pair of top 10 wins this year against James Madison. Last Saturday in the AAC championship, also on this field against Loyola Maryland in March. Florida trailed 7-5. Going into the third quarter in that game. Different team, different time of the year, different circumstances, but this Florida team prides itself on their adjustments, their grit, and their legs in the fourth quarter. But it'll be a tall task to come back against Notre Dame. Emily Diaz for Florida will face Kelly Dennis of Notre Dame. Egan had a step on it and secures it. Over to Hall on the move and takes a push in the back, and that's an immediate yellow. Grace Wigan, the first yellow on Notre Dame today in Florida right after the draw. We'll have the woman up opportunity. Pavanelli, 5 goals in the second half on Friday. She was knocked down, and the flag was already up from behind the play. And that will be another card on the Fighting Irish. This is Schlager who takes a seat. Officials said to Christine Halfpenny that there was contact to the face of Pavanelli, so had to book her. 2 yellows in the first 32 seconds of the half. And Pavanelli, Florida's biggest threat from the 8 meters. She opts to pull it out with Notre Dame down 2 defenders. They set it up inside, and they can't convert. Loose in the crease, and a whistle stops play. Now 2 officials will get together, as they may have different calls. They didn't grant possession to either team. That was with a Notre Dame player down. But it looks like it'll stay with the home team. Or not. Nobody seems to have an idea what's going on now. Florida went back to the dot as if they had possession. Then they dropped it. Then they had a second conference. And now Ashley Gonzalez will trigger in from there. Only 28 seconds gone by on the first yellow. Here in the first minute of the third quarter. Chaos and confusion all about here at the Diz as the clouds roll in. Avanelli trying to whip it inside. She'll have another shot from the arc if she chooses to take it. Pav 12 of 22 in the regular season on free position shots. Back-to-back hat tricks, looking for a second goal here. Won't try to put it on target yet. Pinto with all kinds of space. Finds Hall, who will draw two. She gets the call, but will be from a tough spot. They'll actually move her up a little bit. Still 60 seconds on the shot clock for the possession. All another capable finisher. She'll try her luck and can't put it in, but was fouled on the try. I'll move up closer to the top of the arc. Maggie Hall inside scores. Florida snaps a 10-minute scoring drought. And they trail by two after Hall's second goal of the day. Ninety-eighth in her career for the junior out of Bel Air, Maryland. Eight straight games with 4+ points. Hall has come into her own this season. Florida getting a late sub off. Still 1:15 left on the Keelan Schlageter yellow. So Notre Dame with a possession. They win the draw, they can run it down and still have some time. And some trouble on the draw there. This one doesn't get above either shoulders. And they'll award it to Florida. Gators will have 1 minute left on the advantage. Golden opportunity here as they have been outshot 24-10 today. Still right in it. Notre Dame a couple of chances to take a 4-goal lead late in the first half. Florida got the stop it needed, still within striking distance. Now they look for Waters, nearly picked off and turned over. Great awareness by the Notre Dame defense. They read it beautifully. And now 15 seconds away from full strength. Gonzalez knocks it loose. Wigan controls, stays composed. Notre Dame on the attack for the first time in the second half. Wolak already with 3 goals, Ahern with 2. Choma after a career-high 10 points against Mercer on Friday, been a little quiet. That's the beauty when you have 3 of the best attackers in the country. They draw the switch, and they put it in. Choma from Wolak, and it's back to a 3-goal game. First goal for Choma, scoring on her former club teammate, Kat Flaherty. Just a little screen from Wolak. Gave the separation needed. And even a goalie as good as Sarah Resnick can only make so many point blank stops. That one goes high in the air and to Emily Diaz. Florida has been efficient, so to speak. 6 goals on 10 shots, but also the 8 turnovers really starting to play a part. And the shot disparity. Pavanelli one-on-one will look to go to the middle. Heller with a nice run. She's rewarded. Second goal for Florida's star senior. And a quick response after the Choma goal. Emily Heller, a player, came to campus like so many other athletes in 2020. Earned a starting spot early, was getting a lot of playing time, but then your season's over in a month. And then even as a sophomore, getting a lot of playing time, but still, you're behind 2 greats. A couple of 200-point scorers in Bree Harris and Shannon Cavanaugh on the midfield line. You have to just wait your turn, and Heller, solid. Her junior year, but has fully flourished now in her 4th year for the Gators. One of the most dynamic players in the country, as Notre Dame will get the draw call here. It'll take a team effort for Florida to come back from this 9-7 deficit. Down late stages of the season. It's been Florida's 4th quarter. That's what's been the separator. Pass intended for Choma goes awry. And of course, who else but Heller on the pickup. Florida in transition, it's 3-on-3. And Gonzalez with 3 blue shirts coming back in a hurry will hold up. Gonzalez there with Heller, Waters, Pavanelli, Egan, Hall. Heller spinning inside, lost it. Now 9 turnovers for Florida. They only averaged 12 per game this year. Wolak getting by everybody, sets it up. Ahern couldn't catch it cleanly. And a hold and foul on Bragg. Well, he stops the transition chance for a moment. Everybody will get set up again, but Florida wasting some good opportunities to close in on this 2-goal lead. Shanahan with the score. They'll give it to her. She was right around the crease. Sarah Resnick's asking for it. But she won't get the call. That's going to be worth a second look. Heller playing a little too far back. Shanahan gets her second of the game. First glance, seems like the call's good on the field. It's a play made late by Heller. These two teams trading goals at a halftime. 8:58 left in the third quarter. Winner to play Boston College or Penn on Thursday. Battle for it between sticks, and it's Allie McHugh for Notre Dame. Choma with a point in all 64 career games played. Holds at X with her 1 goal and 1 assist today. And this is where Notre Dame can get more meticulous and surgical. They find Ahern, and the Fighting Irish have their largest lead today. Choma with a pinpoint pass. Put it right where it needed to be, and Davies, only so much you can do as a defender. But the 3 inches, all the difference there. 5-8 on 5-5, and it's 11-7. Florida needs a remedy and in a hurry. If it wasn't the danger zone, trailing by 3 late in the first half, they're certainly in it now. Notre Dame starting to build a cushion as they win another draw. But they throw it away. Looking for Hannah Dorney on the sideline. And a gift given to the Gators. Shots 27-11. Notre Dame getting some second and even third chances on possessions where they would convert. Florida's had a lot of one and done because they've scored on most of their shots, but also turned it over. Pavanelli lost it out of her stick. Lapinto pounces on it. Draw the foul there. Just under 7 minutes left in the third quarter. Hall with a fake and finish. Maggie Hall up to a team high 3 goals and her 9th hat trick of the season makes it 11-8. Too much space, a little miscommunication. And top shelf for Maggie Hall to send us to a timeout. 6:51 left in the third quarter. Florida trying to spark a rally here at home. Just past the midway point of the third quarter here in Gainesville. Notre Dame firing on all cylinders, but a turnover after a draw win sets up Maggie Hall's third goal and 5th point today. Emily Diaz and Liz Harrison have traded chances. They have not been able to solve. Kelly Dennis, game high 6 draws. Notre Dame winning 13 of the 21 here. Only a 3-goal margin for now. Each team scored 3 since the start of the period. But Florida's starting to run out of time from trading goals, and a hold on the Fighting Irish. Gives Florida a chance to bring it to 2. Some of the second line with Cabrera, Hahn, Wehrheim out there. With the starters Lapinto, Hall, Pavanelli, Gonzalez. Hall, 1-on-1. Forced outlet to Pavanelli. 5 goals Friday, 3 goals in the AAC championship. Looking for her second here, throws it away. Hall trying to chase it down, gets to it just in time. Julia Carr to mark.
And a swipe and takedown from behind will help Florida reset with 26 seconds on the shot clock. We'll have a horn from the officials table. Fix the clock before Hall resets. Gonzalez to Lepinto. What a find. What a score. Back-to-back goals for Florida. Make it 11-9. The patience pays off here. Elo with her second goal today. Gonzalez with her first point of the tournament. Sixtieth goal of the season for Emma Lepinto. And her 15th against a top 10 team this year. Florida thought it was their ball. They'll give it to Notre Dame. Paisley Egan was already a couple steps ahead of everybody. Now a chance for Notre Dame to settle in still with a two-goal lead. Looking to get back to the quarterfinals for the sixth time in school history. Didn't know two. 2006, when the program went to its only Final Four. 2009, 2016, and 2021. Davies forced to defend one-on-one against Dorney. Pass out to Abby Machen. Dorney inside. Great look for Machen, just couldn't convert. Quality chance created. Still half a minute on the shot clock. Wolak trying to pick apart this defense again. Now turns the corner, and she'll bounce it past Resnick. Notre Dame just proving to be too much offensively. And right as Florida starts to get back in it, Notre Dame has its answer with Wolak's fourth. You have to worry about her as a feeder so much that sometimes she can do that. Great hesitation. And why she is so elite. Named a third-team All-American by U.S. Lacrosse Magazine. And that's what has really been the difference. Wolak in five games against top 10 teams this year, seven goals, four today. Notre Dame just 1-4 against top 10 teams entering this game today. Lost at Northwestern, at Syracuse. Lepinto on the run, finds the back of the net for the third time. A rare lapse by Notre Dame's defense gives Florida a goal seconds after Wolak's. Diaz was pushing and Lepinto got behind everybody else. Nothing Callahan could do there.
This has been a nice bright spot for Notre Dame. We were just talking how they've struggled against the elite teams this year. Heller almost got it. Dennis lost it. Flies out of the air. Race for the ball. And a foul on Florida. But Notre Dame with that big win against North Carolina. To prove they can play with the best and beat the best. And they're showing they've learned some lessons since those losses in February and March, and even the ACC semis. Bragg does a nice job holding up there. Chomo looking to go one-on-one. Forced to bring it out. Slagater with a stutter. Choma wanted to go middle. Shot clock at 15. Doherty with the spin, the shot, and a save. Loose ball into the air. Browndorf trying to chase it down, and it's Madison Waters. No, it's a foul. Browndorf can't believe her luck, and it's a free position shot for Notre Dame. This has been the difference. Notre Dame plus 7 in ground balls now. And they've created so many extra chances. Well, it's really paying dividends now. Madison Ahern from the 8 will pass it out with a fresh 60 on the shot clock late in the third. Machen forced back by Heller. Ahern can't get it in. And it's dropped in the crease for Resnick by Sars. Sars catches off the lob. The former Mitty from Maryland, moving to defense this year, started every game for the Gators. After trailing 11-7, Florida can get to within one as Notre Dame was off. Pavanelli happy to hold and kill some of this clock. There's about a 12-second differential. Pavanelli starts over to Heller and a whistle. Florida hasn't had too many free position shots today. But it'll be with Heller from the top of the arc. Heller steps up and is stuffed. A collision, Notre Dame ball. Hannah Dorney went down, and Notre Dame can breathe for a moment. Florida racking up the fouls. They have been called for significantly more than the Fighting Irish.
They'll put back 15 and a half seconds on the clock. But it was Callahan's third save right there. That is a huge difference in the final seconds of the third period. Dorney finds a wide open teammate in McHugh. Just throwing it in to see. Nice chance by Ahern, but Resnick was ready. Her 12th save sends us to the fourth quarter in Gainesville. Notre Dame builds a four-goal lead, but Florida comes back. 12-10 our score in this second round matchup. 15 minutes away from sending a team to the quarterfinals in the NCAA Women's Lacrosse Championship. Tom Petty blares over the speakers at Donald R. Disney Stadium in Gainesville. The Gators claim they will not back down. Need to come from behind once again. For the third time in four games, as Sarah Resnick has been nothing short but brilliant once again. A program record 17 saves in the first round Friday. 11 of them here on Sunday. They've been in so many of these moments before, but this will be the toughest. The Gators outscore the Irish 5-4 in the third. What will it take to find the high side on the scoreboard? One would think it starts right here. Diaz has stabilized Florida in draw controls throughout this second half. Good one there. Nice pickup by McHugh as she goes falling down. And Diaz, little too active. Green card on the Gators. Unnecessary. We talk about Florida and the I won't back down mantra. Let's set around all over here. For Notre Dame, a team that is 0-10 all time in true road games in the NCAA tournament. And even this group lost in the first round to Michigan last year, 17-11. This program has made such great strides. They want another chance at the quarterfinals. And right there, Wolak catches the defense napping. No one was ready in a white shirt. And in the first minute, Notre Dame's back up by three. Wolak just turned it on off a little screen from Choma. It was more haphazard than anything. But freed her up and 2 feet of space from about 4 meters out. It's about as automatic as anybody in the country. 11th goal here in Gainesville across the last two games for Jackie Wolak. After an almost perfectly balanced 45 goals, 44 assists in the regular season. Notre Dame 3-for-3 on the advantage today. They'll win another draw here. Feel that's where the approach will start to be as the minutes go down in the fourth. Bit of keep away, but Florida trying to stay composed. Wolak finds the cutter, Machen. Deflection goes right to Choma. Dangerous pass is intercepted. Madison Waters to Pavanelli on the move. Lepinto to Waters, shot, goal. Who else but the player named the unsung hero by her head coach? The defense leads to the offense. And that was poetry in motion. A phenomenal run from the 30-meter mark on one side. All the way to goal. Florida needs a little more of that after Notre Dame's eighth turnover today. They've been so good taking care of the ball. Well, there have been a couple of moments in the second half. Well, they threw the ball out of bounds. That led to an almost immediate Gator goal on one side. And then right there. Talking about some of Florida's miscues and the second chances allowed. It's also just the hustle and effort from Notre Dame. The little things make big things happen. And the door still cracked open. Almost 2.5 minutes into the fourth quarter. Flaherty goes down her sideline. Hands it off to Josie Hahn, and now Danielle Pavanelli. One goal today. All-American have been a little quiet. Just three shots for her. Now attacks Dorney. Finds space and is hit. Pavanelli coming off her 22nd career hat trick Friday. And the sprinter stance here. She'll step up and miss wide. Lepinto couldn't control, and Notre Dame has it.
Callahan hasn't had many saves today, but that's her second on a free position shot. And McHugh clears. There have been a couple of times when Florida could have had a chance to make it a one-goal game. Someone for the Fighting Irish has made a play. Choma off the screen. Feeds X. Ahern. Notre Dame still staying patient, working deep into the shot clock on another possession with 20 left. Slagater. Back to Choma. Resnick got a piece. And the shot clock will go back to 60. Rebound ricochets back out. Wolak triggers in. Already more than 4 minutes gone by in the fourth. Notre Dame 6-2 second quarter, the big difference right now in this second round matchup. That has really been decided by the slimmest of margins. The Notre Dame out shooting Florida 34-17. The big stat that stands out. Despite 12 Sarah Resnick saves. Wolak looking at goal. Dorney with a great flip to Choma and a back-breaking goal against the Gators. Put it on a line to their top attacker. And Choma somehow converts here. Five minutes into the fourth quarter, Florida just had a chance to make it a one-goal game with a free position shot. That's been an area they've really struggled with for the past several games. They don't get it. And Notre Dame, on a second opportunity, gets a goal, 14-11. Harrison couldn't snare it. Doherty does. And finds Dennis. Notre Dame in control now with the ball, leading by three. Definitely call it an upset if the score holds, but Notre Dame, important to note, the number 8 team in the rankings at the end of the season. Florida 6th, like their seed. Notre Dame just the one top 10 win this year. That was against 4th seeded North Carolina. Four losses to the top 3 seeds and to Virginia. Wolak, they try to set it up to Machin, and the deflection goes to Resnick. And now Florida forced to play with some pace, especially on the clears where Notre Dame has made them work, like all the great teams make you. Quick toss to Heller, now Pavanelli. Florida's margin for error, about as close to zero as you can get. Pavanelli inside. Gonzalez, no. Quick possession and the save for Callahan. Her fourth today. A first-year starter still looking for an outlet. Finds what an Anya massacre. Midway through the fourth quarter, the lead has only grown since the start of the period. It was 12-10. With some missed opportunities and plays made by the Fighting Irish. Another goal here, and they can really lock in and feel good about advancing to Thursday's quarterfinal. Choma took a big shot upstairs. Only a foul. .22 seconds on the shot clock. She'll have it just inside of the wing. Two goals, two assists today for the All-American, and she gets her third. Notre Dame has Florida on the ropes. .15 has been the magic number all year for this offense. 10-0 when they reach that mark. Choma delivers. Both teams head to the sidelines. Florida in a world of trouble, trailing 15-11. Here in Gainesville, 15-11 our score with 6:55 to play. Notre Dame with a couple of big goals in the last few minutes. After Madison Waters scored off a turnover she created, it was 13-11 with 13:01 left. But the dominance and the draw and the second and third chances for the offense behind Jackie Wolak and Casey Choma. Notre Dame starting to feel good about a trip to the quarterfinals for the sixth time in program history. Possession to Florida. That's what's so tough for Florida. Only down four, but shots 36-18. It's been the story all day. Turnovers even at nine. The Gators
taking much better care of the ball this half. Again, those 36 shots don't come from the 18-12 advantage in draws. It's winning the ground ball battle. And the rebounds off several saves. Hall gets inside and is pushed down. All with three goals today on three shots. 45% on free position shots this season. Charging in, she waits and scores. Hard to say no Gator has been better than Maggie Hall today. Keeping her team in it with her fourth goal and sixth point. It's just so good with that move. She always likes swiping across. Can always slide and wait for that perfect moment as the goal opens up. Tenth point in the NCAA tournament for Hall. And 83 on the season for the junior. Now, whistle behind the play as Florida looked like it had possession. And a green card is awarded to someone. Caitlin Davies. Not sure if she stepped in the circle too early. Dangerous pass, Lapinto has a read on it, and she goes tumbling down, but they'll say Notre Dame ball still. Oh boy, we'll make the correction there. Pinto got knocked down, the ball also went out of bounds. Seemed to be a moot point. And Notre Dame's off. Julia Carr a little eager. 5:32 left. Three-goal lead for Notre Dame. Florida, a long way to go and a short time to get there, but not impossible. We'll be at even strength for 37 seconds, still serving Davies Green. Carr making her 11th start this year. Bit of a mental lapse there. At least gives Florida a bit of a chance here in the final minutes. Now contact away from the ball. This will be with Madison Waters. Second team AAC midfielder this year. Long Island native, transferring in from USC. And even with time not on their side, Florida going to pull it out. And they will wait to kill the Davies Green. Heller comes across. Yeah, Pinto comes around, waits, and is denied right on the doorstep. And Massacre puts it down. A clutch defensive stop for the Fighting Irish. 4 minutes and 20 seconds away from advancing, and they will call timeout. LaPinto couldn't quite squeeze it in. And Florida's in trouble. Looking around the scoreboard already in an action-packed Sunday with 8 second round games. The number one overall seed, Northwestern, hangs on to beat Michigan 8-7. North Carolina tested by Richmond, looking like they'll advance to another quarterfinal. Richmond gave them all they could handle. They're up 15-12 in the final minutes. And at halftime, Boston College leads Penn 5-2. Score holds, Notre Dame might see the Eagles for a third time this year. Lost 12-11 in South Bend. 9-4 at the ACC tournament in North Carolina. Now they'll have to try to do it in Chestnut Hill. If they hang on here, and Boston College takes care of business in the second half against the Ivy League champs. Florida will do its best to bother whoever has the restart for Notre Dame. Looks like it'll be Hannah Dorney, the vet, playing in her ninth NCAA tournament game, 79th in her career. The captain will stare right at Paisley Egan and Emily Heller. And go back to Callahan. Egan to give chase. LaPinto now around Schlageter. Schlageter forced back by Egan. Brings it back to the keeper. Massacre to Wigan. Takes almost a minute, but Notre Dame clears. Now it's just about killing clock more than looking at Resnick. Even though it's a team that has flat-out dominated first quarters all year, it was the second frame that was the difference. Wolak denied in front. Rebound is still loose, and Florida has it with Flaherty, and they'll immediately call time. Resnick with her 13th save has done all you can ask from a goalkeeper in this one. So now the Gators will regroup, needing a miraculous comeback in the final minutes, but still just enough time. But after a couple of missed opportunities in the fourth quarter, they have their work cut out for them.
2:59 to play. Florida, a team that has won 12 straight games going into this matchup. Last loss came at the hands of James Madison in the regular season. Fell 14-9 in Harrisonburg. That was part of a rough fourth quarter for the Gators. And Andy O'Leary looked back and said that was really the difference for our season. It was our third loss. Well, the first time we lost to a conference opponent, James Madison jumping to the American this year. But really saying how this team found a way to bind together. They had already beaten Loyola Maryland. Been wondering how good they could be, replacing so many starters on defense, needing others to step up in some big games. It hasn't always been easy in another 17-win season for the program. But they found a way to win games with their backs against the wall. Haven't had this kind of performance yet. Ahern and Wolak. They'll try to stop Heller. She splits the two Notre Dame players. In less than 20 seconds, clears it all by herself. Florida's got to go. Tavanelli, one goal on four shots. Inside, LaPinto puts it in. Right off the timeout, Florida only down two thanks to LaPinto's fourth score today. McHugh got caught ball watching for a moment. That's what it's been for each defense. One split second decision has been the difference for so many elite attackers. And now Florida must win a couple of draws. They got the stop, they got the first score. Can't afford to lose a draw here with 2:29 to play. Harrison has it. And as soon as it was in her stick, Florida called time. Notre Dame can't believe it. It wasn't Harrison's stick. But for not even a second. And that is the reason for the officials to come in. Coach Halfpenny has every right to be upset with that call. But it comes down to your interpretation of what's possession. It was in Harrison's stick, but did not take that full step. And obviously, like Florida would, they're just already in their huddle, acting as though the timeout has been granted. And that's one that you're not really going to win an argument with. Christine Halfpenny has been on so many committees in her coaching career. 12th season at Notre Dame. Spent five at the top of the bench with William and Mary. And you see Harrison had it, brought her stick up, and then that's when she lost it. But also we had some of these conversations on Friday where obviously it isn't, the horn's not blowing simultaneously when the timeout's called. There is that little delay with people working at the official scores table. That could be the reason for that mini hesitation where the ball was in the air and that's when we heard the horn. Still, it does bear questioning. Did Harrison have enough possession for that to be in her stick when Reggie Thorpe called timeout from the top of the bench? No matter what Notre Dame thinks, still with a two-goal lead. But Florida with a chance for now. If you think of the five steps, needed the stop on one end, needed the score, then needed the draw, they needed another score, then another draw. It's the five-point plan right now. Obviously, the sixth would be trying to net that tying goal. But we'll make it five instead of six. Right in front, it's Wareheim. Two defensive miscues in the final minutes. Slip behind everybody. And it was Schlageter ball watching. That was a late close by Massacre. Might have gotten hit on the hand too. And Florida catches a big break with the controversial timeout call. And they score immediately. Well, they don't necessarily have to win the draw now with 2:12 to play. But the way this offense has converted and the All-Americans, Notre Dame boasts, Florida feels you got to win another one. Harrison and Dennis to duel. It's put back. It's in the air. Still loose. Three-on-three war for the ball. Egan had it for a moment and finally secures it. Florida trying to do the unthinkable. They trailed 15-11 with 6.5 minutes remaining. Heller comes on late. 90 seconds left. Pavanelli with a run to goal. Taken away at the last moment. Now in front, ties it up! The goal is good from Pavanelli. And Florida has erased a 4-goal deficit in the final 6.5 minutes. Delusion at the Diz as Pavanelli somehow, some way, ties it at 15. Danielle Pavanelli. Second goal today. And now an even bigger draw than the one before. Egan fought for that one. And it leaves to Pavanelli's 47th of the season. Seventh of the tournament. Harrison fumbles it. She has the ball. And a foul just before she loses momentum on the sideline. Notre Dame swarming Egan. And it's knocked away from behind by Ahern. Twice now. But it was Egan who lost her stick. And a yellow card is out. Green card on Egan. Oh, what a play by Madison Ahern. And the Fighting Irish, a chance to play for the last shot. They've squandered a 4-goal lead in the fourth quarter. Casey Choma had the last goal with 6:55 left in the period. Since Hall, Lepinto, Wareheim, and Pavanelli have scored, they nearly take it away from Ahern and now have to play one down for the final minute. Florida's bench jumping up and down saying they're offside. Oh boy, what a fourth quarter between these two teams. But as Florida was gifted one questionable call, the orange and blue not so happy with one that goes against them. Clock is not running on the field. The clock is not running on the field. Everybody on edge here. And just the last thing you'd want in this kind of game, where everyone's BPMs are going towards the roof right now. Notre Dame with 41 seconds left. Florida had the draw in possession, but Notre Dame stuck with it, even as Harrison brought it into the attacking zone, was forced to bring it back through the midfield. And that play could be the difference of playing Thursday and watching on TV. Wolak to Shanahan. Now inside the eight, there it is. Choma falling to her knees. Delivers in the final seconds. Off the green card. Even there through the contact. Choma steps up massively. Her 15th hat trick of the season. It will go down as her biggest. And now Notre Dame calls time with 10 seconds. The little plays late make all the difference. 16-15 Notre Dame. They don't even have to win the draw if they can just cause some trouble. That's it. They're on to Thursday's quarterfinal. And for Florida, just one too many missed opportunities, including the one where they had the draw in the final minute. Pavanelli tied it with 1:22. And after winning the draw, it's Notre Dame's relentless action in the midfield, followed by Egan's green card. And credit to Notre Dame, too. Florida has 5 cards today. Notre Dame's 5 for 5 on the women up opportunities. And that efficiency might just be the difference maker in such a tightly contested second round game between two teams that finished in the top 10. In the regular season, Notre Dame was number 8, Florida number 6. And these two teams have given us a battle and fourth quarter for the ages. And now we will have even more discussions as everybody told to drop their sticks. This fourth quarter has not been for the faint of heart as they will do a stick check on Kelly Dennis. Reggie Thorpe trying to pull out all the stops he can with his team down to the final 10 seconds of their season. And so Notre Dame will use this as another timeout. Already 2.5 hours into this thriller. Florida led it after the first quarter 3-2 after they built a 3-1 lead in the first 6 minutes. But it was Notre Dame surging in the second quarter. They took an 8-5 lead into the break, even with Florida's 10 second half goals. Casey Choma has come alive. 4 goals, 2 assists on the day. And her last one might just be the game winner. What an effort from Florida, trailing 15-11. Scored a goal just before the 6 minute mark. And did every single thing right. And then right after tying it, lost it. And Choma scored on the woman up. So it'll go to Notre Dame. Dennis' stick ruled legal. And the Fighting Irish can just run around with the ball for the final 10 seconds. Notre Dame slips up late, but scores in the final seconds, and for the sixth time in program history, are on to the quarterfinal round of the NCAA tournament. They fight and use everything it takes to claim a 16-15 win over the Florida Gators. And for the first time this tournament, one of the hosts are done. Taking a look at our updated bracket, Notre Dame one win away, not just from tying a school record 16th win in a single season, but from their second ever Final Four. Boston College currently up 7-5 at the start of the fourth quarter in Chestnut Hill. Will Notre Dame have a third chance on Thursday to beat BC? We'll find out later. What a thriller. Thank you so much for joining us. Notre Dame wins at 16-15. For our wonderful crew, I'm Sean Salisbury saying good afternoon from Gainesville.